2008, the East Japan Railway Company installed a floor at Tokyo Station that generates electricity every time a person step on it. They use this generated electricity to operate ticket gates and display systems. The same technology is also used in a club in San Francisco. They use this in the dance floor to power lights. This is interesting. It seems this floor generates electricity when it experiences some pressure. Scientists took this technology to another level. They thought it would be good if they installed this in a busy road where it can experience constant pressure from the moving vehicles. Now, you might be curious about this magical floor. To know about this, continue watching. Hi, I'm Vanilla and this is The Learning Curve. Before learning about the mystery of the flow, let's first learn about an interesting physics concept, piezoelectric effect. In 1880, Jack Curie, along with his younger brother Pierre Curie, found that when they hit certain type of crystals, including quartz, tourmaline, and Rochelle salt along certain axes, a voltage was produced on the surface of the crystal. This is the result of the crystal's microscopic structure. Crystals are defined by the organized arrangement of atoms in repeating pattern. This repeating unit is called a unit cell. In most crystals, the atoms in their unit cell are distributed symmetrically around a central point. Some crystalline materials don't possess this center of symmetry, making them candidates for piezoelectricity. Not all non-centrosymmetric crystals are piezoelectric materials, but all piezoelectric materials are non-centrosymmetric. They might not be symmetric, but they are electrically neutral. That means they have equal number of positive and negative charges. If we apply mechanical pressure, the structure deforms, atoms get pushed around, pushing the negative charge to one side and the positive charge to the other. Now, the crystal acts as a kind of tiny battery with positive charge on one face and the negative charge on the opposite face. The current flows if we connect two faces together to make a circuit. What if we bury crystals under city streets to capture energy as cars and other vehicles pass by? The crystal is placed about 5 cm below the surface of the asphalt. The asphalt is elastic and the pressure of each tire that passes it slightly deforms the crystal, thereby producing electricity. Here, the electricity is generated from vehicles' weight, motion, and vibration. The produced electricity can be stored in a battery or can be connected to a grid. It could also be used to power the street lamps, traffic signals, and car charging stations. If planted along 1 km stretch of road, an average of 400 kW of power can be generated. The busy roads and heavy vehicles produce more electricity. The best thing is the drivers won't even feel a difference. The piezoelectric material lasts for at least 30 years, which is more life than the life of most roads. It can also be used on railways and airline runways. The problem is installing these devices and keeping them running would add to the cost of road maintenance. And engineers might be tempted to design the roads to vibrate just a little more than the normal to increase the efficiency of the harvesting, thus causing the roads to crumble even faster. What do you think? Can piezoelectric technology provide large-scale power? Is piezoelectric highway possible? Don't forget to share your thoughts in the comment section below. Bye, see you in my next video.